Hi, my name's Carl Rosenthal, and welcome to another module in the course of migrating from Windows XP through to Windows 8.1. As always, my contact details are on there, so at Windows PC Guy, if you do want to contact me via Twitter. And this is obviously part of an entire course that's being held on the Microsoft Virtual Academy. So if you haven't checked out the other modules, then please make sure you do. So this module is a pretty basic one. It's about installing Windows 8.1 directly onto Windows XP machine. So within here, we're not really looking at anything fancy. We're not looking at any imaging or anything like that. We're just simply doing an installation. And when we do that, what we're going to look at as part of this is we're going to have a look at the how to perform a Windows 8.1 installation. So what sort of different methodologies we've got, and what the different methods of installation are. As well as some of the steps that we might take along the way as well. And depending on how you're wanting to do this, will depend on what we're going to put into place. And then also look at some of the files and the folders that are created and what they're going to be useful for. If you are doing a migration that's not part of a larger scale migration, say for instance the CEO comes in and they've gone out to the local computer shop on the weekend and bought a Windows 8.1 DVD and they want to be able to do an installation. How do you sort of handle that onto their XP box? So the installation steps, pretty basic sort of things. Essentially, download, create, or purchase the Windows 8.1 DVD or ISO. Or if you've already migrated across into 8.1 or 8.8, then it's obviously just an upgrade step from there. But in our case, we're looking at it from migrating from XP. We need to get a hold of the media somehow, right? So that could be through your software assurance. It could be through MSDN. If you're looking to do this as a trial, you can also download eval software from TechNet as well to be able to just to see how your upgrade process will work. Then you need to consider what's going to happen. Either do you want to retain the settings? Do you want to keep the settings carrying over? And if you do, then you're going to have to make sure you run USMT first. So that's all the files and settings that we're going to transfer across. If you are using USMT, make sure you do check out the module that we've got on USMT, which tells you all about how to actually put that into place and what to use. And you then have the consideration as to what sort of version of USMT you want to do. Do you want to do a hard link migration? So in other words, leave all the files in the same location and just create links to the NTFS location of the files. Or do you want to do a normal USMT, in which case we need to have additional space to be able to push the files and settings out to, so for some storage. Then run the installation from the DVD. Make sure you're actually logged on to Windows in order for this to happen. So you're already logged into Windows XP, then run the installation. And the reason for that is because it creates a particular folder if we do that, and we'll discuss that shortly. It creates the win.old folder. And after your installation is complete, install any of the applications that you want to put back. Now you have to reinstall them because as part of doing the installation of Windows 8.1, it does wipe entirely all of the applications. Probably rewinding that a little bit before you go ahead and do this. There's a compatibility wizard or an upgrade wizard that will enable you to work out if you're potentially going to have any issues with doing the migration. So any of the applications that you might have that may not run properly under Windows 8.1, or things such as items that might need to be uninstalled and reinstalled in order for them to successfully work. An example of that, say for instance, if you're doing an iTunes, if you've got iTunes, you need to make sure that you actually uninstall that before you do your install of 8.1. And the reason being because otherwise it'll count as an additional count of your licenses. So, it's little things like that that the actual upgrade wizard will advise you of. So, once you've done your installation, install applications and then run USMT. concept and remembering back from our USMT module that this is then running a migration to be able to do a load state. So the first one's a scan state, and also remembering that we've got two different versions that you have to look at. So, you know, make sure you catered for that as part of your environment. And then final step, if it is a domain joined box, then also make sure that you do your domain join as well. So, what do we need to be able to install? Okay, so the requirements are actually not too harsh, you know, like sort of. So we need to have a processor, 1 gig or faster. We do have to have support for PAE, NX, and SSE2, and that's the thing that may trip you up with some of the older machines. So make sure you do check that out before you go ahead and try to do an upgrade, because otherwise it won't work. It'll reject you before you get started. And the amount of memory that you need to have. So you need to have at least 1 gig of memory for a 32-bit or 2 gig for 64. And obviously, depending on what the applications are that you run on top of the environment will depend on what else you might need to have in addition to that. Particularly, say, for instance, if you're running Hyper-V, then Hyper-V will have some additional, like if you're running client Hyper-V, that'll have some additional requirements for memory as well. So hard disk space, how much hard disk space should you actually allow for 8.1 to be able to install? So again, depending on which version you put in place, if you're using 32-bit, then we need a 16 gig worth of space. If you're doing 64-bit, then 20 gig worth of space. But again, allow for growth with regards to items such as your like applications that you install, and any of the data that you might want to store as well. Don't forget that as part of 8.1, we've now got all the built-in connections across to things like SkyDrive, so there may not necessarily be a requirement to have as much onboard storage as long as you have access to be able to get to the web. From a graphics card perspective, again, pretty light with regards to the requirement. And again, depending on what applications you will run will depend on what you need to have on top of that. But, you know, essentially a Microsoft DirectX graphics device should be able to suffice you to be able to use the, like, install the operating system and use it for the majority of your of applications. It's when you start getting into CAD, CAM sort of applications, or alternatively, you know, some gaming applications, that's when maybe you might have some higher requirements. But from the OS perspective, it's actually pretty light. So what about additional things that you might need to have in place? And again, this just depends on what you need to use. Okay, so to use touch, obviously you need to have a tablet or a monitor that supports multi-touch. Don't forget, though, that, you know, Windows 8.1 is... it will work successfully without a touch device. It will certainly work very well on a touch device, but it'll also work without, like, you know, work without a touch device. All of the menu systems, all of the charms and that sort of thing are all designed to be able to be accessible via either a menu item, or sorry, by a mouse click, or via touch. So both of them will work. To access the Windows Store and to run and download and also to snap applications, then first off you need to have an active internet connection. You also have to have a screen resolution of at least 1024x768. And again, that's probably fairly light on requirements for most organizations and most devices nowadays. If you're using Secure Boot, then you have to make sure that you've got firmware that supports the Secure Boot in order for that to work. If you're using BitLocker to go, then obviously we have to have a USB flash drive that's actually that has the capability to run it. With BitLocker to go, we have to have the capability to be able to run it, which essentially is just a USB disk. Okay, if we're using BitLocker, then either the onboard TPM, or alternatively using a flash drive. And if you're using a flash drive, then what that gives you the ability to do is to store the unlock key somewhere else, as opposed to using the onboard TPM. And as I mentioned before, if you're running client Hyper-V, then we've got some additional requirements for client Hyper-V as well. So requires 64-bit as a base, and also has to have SLAT capabilities, and an additional 2 gig of memory. Now, that additional 2 gig of memory will also depend, like, as a... how much you want to have extra will depend on what you're running as well. If you're running multiple multiple virtual machines, then obviously you have to be able to have enough memory to address within those as well. So when we go to do an installation of Windows 8.1 over Windows XP, it creates this very handy but often misunderstood folder, which is the Windows.old folder. And essentially what that does is that creates all the files and settings that were in XP get dumped into the Windows old folder. Okay. Now the Windows old folder, even if you say, like, take the option to say don't carry anything across when you go to do your installation of Windows 8.1, the Windows.old folder actually gets created anyway. What happens is, though, is that after a period of time, so after 28 days, most of the content that's contained in it automatically gets deleted. So what you want to do if you migrate from Windows XP to Windows 8.1, the Windows.old folder gets created. You want to be able to drag everything out of there that you require within that 28 days. Okay. After that, as I said, there's an automatic deletion that goes across to effectively clean up the disk. There is also a disk cleanup utility, the built-in disk cleanup utility that you can use, and what that does is that gives you the ability to be able to delete all the Windows.old files as well. So that's how you actually do a full cleanup. So you're just going in and deleting the folder itself doesn't clean up all the records of it, so use the disk cleanup utility to be able to do the full cleanup. And in addition, just one thing that I often get asked about this is that if you do delete the Windows.old, if there was files and folders that you had as part of USMT using hard link migration, what happens to the files? Well, deleting the Windows.old doesn't delete those files. Okay, those files are still retained. Remembering back to our hard link migration discussion, that essentially the files themselves will always exist. It's just the links to them that get put away. So the link within the Windows.old folder, if there are any there that are repeated in a USMT hard link, then it's effectively the hard link. It's just an additional link that you'll delete, as opposed to deleting the file itself that lives underneath. So in summary, a couple of things. So certainly USMT to transfer your files and settings. And we discussed right back in module one, our introduction module, that there's also the possibility, or there used to be a possibility of using the Windows Easy Transfer. And Windows Easy Transfer does still exist under Windows 8.1, but it doesn't, it's not the same, compatible with the Windows Easy Transfer that's in Windows XP. So you're kind of one version too many ahead, so therefore it won't work through. So the other option, also the other thing to bear in mind, is make sure that you start from within Windows XP. So kick off from within Windows XP, therefore all the process will actually be carried through properly if we're doing the migrate on the local box. Now this is, again, manual. We're not automating anything. This is just simply putting in the ISO file, putting in the DVD, and then kicking off the installation. And then once you've completed using it, make sure you do run the disk cleanup to delete the Windows.old folder. So once you've completed your upgrade process or your migration. So some useful links, and again these are part of the slide deck that you can download from the MVA course. So using the Windows.old folder, and what sort of things to use for it, how to restore files out of it, all part of the link that's on there. And again, useful to the Springboard series. The Springboard series being the IT Pros, IT Pro specialist website, with regards to doing migration, deployment, support, etc. for Windows 8.1, and then also the TechNet forums for 8.1. So if you do have any questions or anything like that, you can also post them into there. And there's MVPs, there's people from all around the world, MCTs, just general hobbyists that will jump in, as well as some Microsoft folks as well that haunt the forums. And as always, if you do have any other questions as well, please feel free to send me a tweet as well, and we'll see what we can sort out. So a couple of other useful links for you. And again, these are ones you've seen before, but the TechNet Eval Center. So, you know, make sure you go there to be able to download any of the eval bits to be able to try this out. And the idea is certainly if you're practicing your migration, you know, you don't have to burn up your production keys for it. You can actually just use the eval keys and the eval bits to be able to do it. Also, don't forget the IT camp, so make sure you do visit the technet.microsoft.com/global-IT-camps to be able to see what sort of local training there might be from Microsoft that will be visiting you to be able to you know, get you up to speed with deployment management and essentially, yeah, any of the new technologies that are coming out. Generally, there'll be an IT camp that runs around with it throughout the world, as well as obviously the MVA, so the Microsoft Virtual Academy, which is where you got this from. Make sure you check out the other courses that are available. Also, don't forget to complete the trivia questions that go along with this, the exam questions, which will then make sure that it contributes towards the points that you earn for the MVA. So my name's been Kyle Rosenthal, and this is part of the presentation for the migrating from Windows XP to Windows 8.1 course on MVA, and I'll see you on the next course. Thank you very much.